space. Up until now, only governmental agencies like NASA have been able to send people into space, but not anymore. No, sir. We are going to space. Now, before you say anything, yes, I am wearing a Poe Dameron suit, but we are talking about space. Space startups, to be more exact. Companies like Virgin Galactic and SpaceX are trying to send people into space and send things into space affordably. Actually, Virgin Orbit has invited me to their facilities, so let's go. We're going to
Los Angeles! I'm here at the Virgin Orbit plant, and this is the cafeteria. You can see people eating, and I obviously want to show you everything else, but it's going on over there, and it's top secret. But hey, there's a CEO. So my friend Ming-Si here is a materials engineer.
A materials engineer basically means I deal with anything having to do with whatever anything is made out of, but I focus especially on metals.
So what makes your rockets different from like SpaceX's rockets?
Couple things. So first of all, our rocket is much smaller than SpaceX's rocket, for example. We're launching from a Boeing 747 airplane. So basically it's gonna fly up into air, basically how, you know, we normally fly a plane, and then we're gonna drop a rocket from the wing, and then the engines are gonna fire, and then we're gonna go into orbit. This actually means we have more flexibility launching from anywhere we want in the world. So we can literally pick up a payload from anywhere, say, you know, if we had a Canadian customer from the middle of Canada, and then straight from there, fly to where we need to launch from, instead of currently most launch vehicles are limited to just Florida.
Is launching from mid-air different from launching from the ground in terms like weather and stuff like that?
In a way, yes. We do get better conditions in that we have better control on where we can take it, so we're not limited to, oh, we have to stay in one place and we have to deal with the weather there. Yeah. We can kind of choose where to go there.
Have you ever been on the plane?
I have not, but we are sitting on the seats from the plane, so that's basically the same thing.
We're basically on a plane.
We're basically on a plane.
Gonna launch a rocket, BRB. Thanks, Minx.
Yeah, good to see you again.
See you in space.
See you there.
Okay, now I'm gonna go see some people to talk about how this space startup thing actually works, but not this guy. He doesn't know much. So I'm here in the middle of the Virgin Orbit plant with Will, the VP of Special Projects.
Hi, everyone.
So I wanted to ask, why are startups now trying to get into space?
Well, I think space has always been fascinating to people for lots of different reasons, whether it's just personal significance or scientific or social or military or whatever else. The thing that's changing now is it's becoming a lot cheaper.
How is it cheaper? So what got cheaper?
Well, technology got cheaper. So as everything gets smaller, as everything gets faster, as everything gets lighter weight, those kind of innovations, a lot of which were born in the space industry and then sort of got perfected in other industries, are starting to flow back into the commercial space.
So what kind of companies would want to partake?
It's lots of different companies. So if I look just at our customer manifest here at Virgin Orbit, first of all, NASA's a customer of ours. They're a really important customer of ours. But we've got lots of other different types of customers as well. One of the ones we're most excited about is a privately funded company called OneWeb, and they're going to be launching hundreds of satellites that they'll use to provide high bandwidth, low latency, broadband internet connectivity all over the surface of the Earth.
How affordable is Virgin Orbit?
So let's say right now you've got a satellite and you've got a briefcase full of cash out in the trunk of your car.
Yeah.
First of all, let's talk about that. That's pretty exciting. But also, if you were to go to another rocket company right now and want to fly, you're gonna have to wait a couple of years and you're gonna have to fork over, you know, $50+ million. What we're trying to do is get that down from 50-ish to 12-ish, and to make it from you have to wait for several years, 3 or 4 years, down to you have to wait for a couple months before you can get your satellite into orbit.
So you've worked with Virgin Galactic as well.
Yeah.
So space tourism is something that everyone wants to do. So I heard in the news that like Katy Perry and Justin Bieber bought tickets. How is that feasible? How can you bring people to space in like a big like bus tour kind of way?
It's going to space, but only just barely. We're gonna get you to the official border of space and a little further than that. So you get the full experience, you earn your astronaut wings, you're official, a legitimate astronaut. But by keeping the distance we're traveling a little bit lower, it both lowers our costs, and it also means that from a medical perspective, just about everyone is healthy enough to fly on that vehicle.
When can we expect it?
It's pretty soon now. So you've gotten a chance to see some of the hardware here in the Virgin Orbit facility. As you can tell, we're getting pretty close. You know, we've built several full rockets worth of material. Yeah. We've been testing them for a long time out in the desert. We've been firing our rocket engines at very long duration at full thrust. So our hope is that we'll be flying our first satellites all the way into orbit in the first half of next year. And our sister company, Virgin Galactic, similar kind of thing. Wow. We got a lot more testing to do before we're comfortable putting passengers in the back of it, but we're getting there.
Are people who go to space with Virgin Galactic considered astronauts?
Yeah, absolutely. So here in the United States, anyone who exceeds an altitude of 50 miles above mean sea level, you're considered an astronaut.
Can I get a free ticket?
We can talk. We need to do some kind of a media junket. You gotta be able to go up and write the good reviews, right?
All right, well, nice to talk to
Thanks
you.
Thanks for coming to visit us.
Guys, look how cool this is. Bye, guys.
Bye.
All right, I just got back, and it's super cool. Who would have thought that space could be like a startup idea? Just a couple of years ago, even the thought of sending things into space seemed like a billion, multi-trillion dollar idea. And now they're trying to send people into space for like hundreds of thousands of dollars. That's so cool. And he did say he's gonna launch that satellite rocket next year. So it seems like big things are happening. And Will did promise me that Virgin Galactic ticket. So I'm gonna hold him to that. You're gonna see me become an astronaut. Just you wait. All right, guys, I'm out. I'll see you later. Bye.
I'm gonna go build a rocket now. Bye.